This is Tasha from PaintScout. Today I'm going to be showing you how to estimate a hallway using time-based rates. Now, the hallway that we're going to be estimating today, we are brushing and rolling. We're going to be painting all of the walls, the six doors and door frames, as well as the trim. The trim includes the baseboards, as well as these two little trim pieces along the wall that you might notice. Just before we begin, just to give you a little bit of background, we're going to be painting the walls a pretty similar color. It's going to be kind of a lighter beige color, so probably just we'll need two coats for decent coverage on those. And then for all of the trim, the doors, door frames, that's all going to be going a white color. So for all of those, we're going to be having to prep them a little bit, do some sanding, and then we're going to need to prime them and do two coats of paint on top of it. With the doors, as you might notice, you know, a lot of that wall space is taken up by the doors, but since we are going to have to take the time to cut around each of the door frames, just according to PCA standards, we're still going to include that wall square footage, simply because it would take us just as much time, if not longer, to cut around all of the doors than it would be if we were just going to roll the wall space. You might also notice on the one side, it's a little bit of a shorter wall that goes along there, but because we still will need to be cutting the top and cutting the bottom and then rolling in between, we're going to basically make that act as just a wall in general. We're not going to actually take down the square footage of that, simply because we are still going to have to take the time for the cutting and the rolling. Again, that is just a PCA standard. If you do feel a little bit more comfortable lowering that square footage, feel free, but I'll show you how we do it using PCA standards. So when you first log into PaintScout, of course, you have your dashboard settings pop up here. We're gonna go to creating a new estimate. Of course, the estimate type that we'll be choosing is interior, since it is an interior hallway. Of course, you can choose a template, but I'll just show you how quickly it is from an empty one here. Now, first thing you're going to do to add on your estimate will be your contact. Of course, you want to include your contact information and the job address as well. This one's just taking place at the same address as our contacts, so we'll just click that button. Now, when you're actually building your estimate, of course, you're going to be prompted by choosing either an area or a line item. So firstly, we're going to include a line item just to go over a little bit of the interior preparation standards that our client can expect of us. So we'll go into here and we're going to choose interior preparation. Within our interior preparation, we already have a bunch of text already built out in here. Of course, you can change this if you want to add something or, you know, take something out of it, but this is pretty accurate for this job, so we'll just leave it as is and go ahead and add that item. Now, on the other side, of course, we have our area. So we'll go into creating our area. Of course, we can have a bunch of different ones, but we'll click on our hallway since that's what we're estimating today. Now, this hallway is 16 feet long, and then it's 3.5 meters wide. So we're gonna go ahead and include that in here. And then it's just 8 feet tall. So again, you know, that one wall is a little bit shorter, but we're still gonna be cutting and rolling it. So we're just gonna leave it as is. Our linear footage, walls and ceilings and floor square footage will all automatically be calculated for us. We'll hit confirm. Now from here, we're going to include our different substrates that we're painting. So of course, we're brushing and rolling the walls, the six doors, door frames, and trim. So firstly, in walls, of course, you're going to have a bunch of different rates set up. These ones are just some pretty standard walls. There's not much prep. There's not much, you know, sanding or filling that we're going to need to do. So we'll just go with the 85 square foot an hour. As you can see, all of your painting hours, material, labor, and total price is all automatically calculated for you. To take a look at how that's broken down, of course, you have your rate here. We're just doing the two coats, so we can leave that as is. And same with prep, there's not much extra prep needed, so we can just leave it, those numbers as they appear. And then we also have our material calculated down below. And then if you wanted to change your product, you could always go in here and change it, but we're just going to use this Sherwin-Williams Emerald. Now, once you've included your walls, it's really just plug and play putting in our different substrates. So we're going to go in and include the trim. We're doing the baseboards. Now within baseboards, of course, we do have a little bit of extra prep that we're needing to sand those down, get the current current feeling off of that. We're also going to include 3 coats for these ones since we are going to need to prime it and have the 2 coats of paint. And then since we are using 3 coats on here, we can include our material. Now the same thing is going to be true for those doors and door frames since we're going to need to do a little bit of extra prep on them and then also 3 coats. So we go into our doors and then you can choose to do it separately, your doors and your door frames, but just for ease of use, we'll do the door and the frame together. Now we have 6 of these. We'll go back into them, make sure we have our 3 coats included, and then it's going to be closer to maybe 2 hours of prep because we will need to be sanding those all down, doing a little bit of caulking, filling, just to make sure that we have that all accounted for. And then the last little bit we're going to need to include is those 2 little trim pieces, and we're actually going to include that as a custom rate, and we'll do these. We'll label that trim pieces. And these are going to be in hours per item. We have 2 of those, and each one's going to take about 30 minutes. So we can just include it like that. And then we'll include 3 coats. And as you can see, it's all calculated for you. So not going to take too much time, but just want to make sure we do include those. Once you have all of your substrates all built out, we'll go ahead and add that area. Now, if we want to include a picture, just to clarify, you know, maybe with our painters, what the trim pieces are referring to, we'll go in and add some media in here. And once that's added in there, we'll just make a note for trim. And if you wanted to just have that on just the work order and not show it to your customer, you could of course take it off the estimate, but this is no biggie. This always helps to just clarify with both your customer and your painters, so not necessarily a bad idea to include that on there. And then once you've added it, of course you'll have your media section down below with your title and your notes. So now, as you can see, you have your walls, baseboards, door and frames, and your trim pieces. If you do want to add a little bit more detail to any of these, you can always click on the substrate and add in some notes to show to your customer or some notes to show to your crew. And you can also have a little bit more information shown right on the estimate itself. For instance, if you want to show how many coats and what product, you can even include the color as well, just depending on maybe what they ask you and what they want to see. So this is how you build out an estimate for a hallway using time-based rates. If you're looking to learn a little bit more about how to price projects using these time-based rates, PaintScout really is the best platform to do so. And we do have a lot of other videos. You can check out the link down below, or you can always reach out at support@paintscout.com. Thanks for watching.